That'd be an expense getting us on. Yeah.
Full order, the February 7th, 2017, Scott Township Planning Commission meeting. Rise to the pledge.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I realize it's February, but this is our first meeting of the year, so we have to do a quick little reorganization to keep everything on the up and up. At this time, I'll open nominations for Chairman of the Planning Commission for 2016 Chair with Bob Sikowski, who is out of town this year.
I'll make a motion to make Bob Chairman again.
Second.
Any nominations? Hearing none, I will close nominations. The next position open is Vice Chairman. 2016, that was myself. Nomination for Vice Chairman.
I will. I nominate you. Vice Chairman.
Second. Any others? Close nominations for Vice Chairman. I'll open nominations for Secretary.
Joe.
You're the door of that.
Pardon me?
You're Secretary last year, I believe?
No.
Go ahead.
You're former. I'm available. Not available 5 months because of work, so that's what I'll pass on.
For nominations for Secretary. So.
You're just answering.
Yeah.
Okay, Joe nominated Patrick. For a second?
I'll second.
Any other nominations? Hearing none, and since all three positions are unopposed, as Chairman of the organizational meeting, I will cast a long vote to elect this slate of Bob Sikowski as Chairman, Phil Kaiser as Vice Chair, and Pat Casper as Secretary for 2017. We have a poll that we can.
Yes. So we want to take for Tuesday.
Last several years, our meetings have been on the first Tuesday of the month at 7 o'clock. I would like to maintain that routine. So we have a motion to have our 2017 meetings as they're required on the first Tuesday of the month at 7 o'clock.
I make a motion to have the meeting on the first Tuesday of the month at 7 o'clock.
Second?
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Hearing no other business for the organization. Move on to the approval of the minutes from the September 28th meeting. Comments or corrections on the minutes? That was part of that day, so I can't wait to comment on them. Hearing none, do I have a motion to accept the minutes as presented?
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes for September 28, 2016.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. All right. Piazza Minor Subdivision.
This is a one-lot subdivision.
off of Lake Road. Maybe it was like the last driveway, it's off private road, it's the last driveway in the township actually.
All the way down there?
Yeah. It's, currently there's the entrance to the roadway as well as two four-unit apartment buildings on the property. And that is on over 15 acres. This subdivision is to subdivide off one, lot, which will be 1 acre, down behind those apartment buildings, which will leave remaining lands, including the apartment buildings, of 14.84 acres, which, is consistent with our ordinance, because there's 8 units there, there has to be at least 8 acres with those buildings. So there will be 14. And this is a 1 acre building lot, which will connect to the central sewer. The, planning waiver for the DEP is in process, there's a couple papers we haven't yet signed yet. But the county has reviewed this and approved it. And it would have to be, approved here, it would have to be pending, the DEP waiver for hookup to the central sewer. The apartment buildings are already hooked to the sewer, so the sewer line is actually 35 feet away from the lot, so.
Sewer authority said?
Yes, yeah, I have to get the signed letter from them, from the Blackwater River Basin, but, we'll go for it.
Is there a agreement in place for cement milling?
That is a, deed of easement all the way through that's existing for, this entire property, because this, this is part of it, yeah, right, it remains, with the owner. So we're not actually even changing that, that's already, that already goes through San Isidro's property, that's already existing.
Anything on here that's gonna force the, agreement under the law? My concern is that cement milling, prior granted easements here and all that, if there's agreements in place to do any maintenance, that this new lot winds up with those same requirements on it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do understand. Currently, it's all failing, but you're right, that was always, that's always gonna be so. I said, is it deed of easement through there? I don't know that they have, if you guys have any kind of a maintenance agreement on that. I mean, it's a legally deed of easement, so.
What about the easement?
It's a legally deed of easement, so that's not an issue, because that's pre-existing, so we don't need to be concerned with that, however.
Oh, you're talking about the easement that came down the road, right?
The one that goes all the way through, yeah. If you guys have any kind of a maintenance agreement, only because you have San Isidro's.
Oh, yeah, we have, my sister that owns this, these properties, she takes care of the road and easement, yeah. It tells the deed that she takes care of this.
Okay, so San Isidro, basically, you go free ride.
Yeah, basically, yeah. Yeah, and this is my brother has a house, it's right there. My sister runs these two, and my wife and I were looking to put a small house up on this 1 acre.
So it is in her deed that she maintains?
Yeah, it's in her deed.
I'm sure there's, these lots had some covenants requiring maintenance on, I'm sure they're also placed on here, so that, you know, it's all shared evenly.
Right.
But it's all on her.
It's on her, yeah.
It's all on her.
Yeah. It's on her deed only, yeah.
I'm satisfied with that.
The county note, the only thing they made a notice of was that the, remaining land and the building lot both, touched the 100-year floodplain, but There's no building proposed for those areas, so it wasn't an issue. Yeah, way down the end here, it goes through this hedge here.
It's actually in the setback.
Right, from already, yeah, right, so it's where they're looking to build is not an issue, and that's what Kelly said to you.
So we still need a formal response from DEP, right?
Yeah, we, normally what we'll do is prove the pending submission of all the letters and everything.
Who's on Sherman, can we raise the motion?
Pending processing of the.
Yeah, it's in DEP's on account, we have the county back.
Right, county back.
Okay.
That is here. Wrap around that.
Do I have a motion to accept the Merrick minor subdivision, contingent upon DEP approval?
I'll make a motion to accept the Piattone subdivision, minor subdivision, pending DEP sewer.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Any comments? Any question? All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Get it, Bob, if you want to stop it, so you can get that other stuff together.
Paper for DEP? Well, thank you so much, guys.
Next on our agenda is review of conditional use application for having the second hospital.
So after a really long time, I don't know. This is a conditional use application for,
For nunchucks.
I never heard it referred to as that, but I like where you're going. Is this okay in the middle?
Yeah, absolutely. Abington Equine Hospital, which is proposed for the property on the corner of Stone Road and 524. Great road over, Yablonski's old property.
Yes.
In the corner. It's 11.7 acres.
Something like that.
Yes. That is a DD zone, it is a conditional use in that zone.
Have extras. Share a little bit.
My name is Bob Negley, I'm the civil engineer consultant. The auditors are here with me, and I'm gonna let them introduce themselves so I don't mess up their names.
I'm Kat Radke.
Brad Back.
Just so you're aware, they had approached me a while back with the idea and a concept, and we've been working with a builder, architect, and a couple other folks. Still trying to get our head wrapped around the building itself. In that meantime, we came up with a conditional use plan based on basically the parameters they set forth and the size of the building and how they want to access the site and use the facility. So obviously we're here, it's a preliminary plan. It's for informational purposes to start the conditional use hearing, and then we will give a little quick description and then open it up to questions, and I'm sure these two can supply you with other business program information. Now, 524, if you look at it from Google Maps or other maps I've seen, has at least two names I saw. So I have it listed as Hill Road, I've seen it called Kennedy Creek Road.
It's Hill Road until it leaves the township, which is just down past the next Yablonski property, then it changes to Craig Road or Creek Road or Kennedy Creek Road.
I've seen it called, yeah, and then same thing with Stump Road, I've seen Stone Road.
Yeah, Stone School Road.
Exactly. So, you know, I never knew that till the end. I've been driving these roads too long and never realized they had that many names. But anyhow, as you can see, the yellow lot line is the existing property line. That was subdivided in about 95 by John Siemens. There was perk testing performed on what we'll call the northwest corner of the property. And you can see our aerial map is a little older. That structure is actually gone. So, but it's down in that corner. What they propose to do is come off of 524, enter the facility, and then have one-way traffic circulating around 7,500 square foot building. What we show on the backside here is kind of big picture items. We want to present it. This is their vision or some variation thereof where, you know, maybe they have the barn out back or some storage buildings and access to circulate around the site just to support their services. So their accessory structure, if you will, to the primary use. But again, come in, enter, you see that little jug handle loop there. That's for the horse trailers and trucks to pull off if they've got unload, gives them a way to keep circulation around the building. We're showing, I believe, 12 parking stalls right now. Again, we got to dive into the code a little bit further. I didn't see anything off the top that really drove the parking number. We could call this building a lot of different things.
Right.
So I think we got to work with you folks to talk about it.
Yeah, there's not, I mean, she, based on the number, it's not going to be like some walking clinic. So
right.
Based on the number of employees that you're going to have there currently, bring them up.
The normal square footage thing
right.
doesn't
yeah.
work because
yeah.
it's, well.
That's right. That's right. And that's kind of why, you know, we could fit more parking. We've got 11 acres.
Yeah.
So if push comes to shove, we definitely have room. I mean, you know, it's going to be driven by what they need to operate and what, you know, makes Scott Township comfortable as well. So, you know, again, we understand we're at the very early stage of this. We know we've got a lot of road in front of us to get this approved and through planning commission. We need to deal with PennDOT. We need to deal with the conservation district who happens to be right down the hall. And we've already approached them to talk to them about certain things. And, you know, other than that, it's a pretty straightforward project. I will point out one other thing. You'll see a gate indicated in the main driveway. And we don't show it on the plan, but there are ideas for fencing, so obviously there's containment and stuff. Because I assume you will have horses at some point walking around out there.
That is the idea.
So, without any further distraction from the plan, I'm going to leave this up here and want these two to tell you a little bit about what they do, because I'm sure that's a question that will come up as well. So,
so we're both equine veterinarians, obviously. My husband does general equine practice and the ambulatory part of the service, and that part of our service has been open since August 15th. That's when we started our company. I'm a surgeon, an equine surgeon, large animal surgeon, so I'm the one who needs the building. So this is my baby. Basically, you know, this is something that's important to this area. I don't know if any of you have horses, but people in this area right now where they need surgical services would have to travel 2 to 2.5 hours north to Cornell or same distance but south to New Jersey. So right now that money's kind of leaving our state, which we think is silly. It's just kind of a niche that's not been filled in this area. We do have some other ambulatory vets, but actually not a whole lot of them. Some of them do mixed animal practice and that sort of thing, which is great, but that means they know a lot about, or a little bit about a lot of different animals, and we know a lot about one animal. So it's a little bit of a specialty service that way, where we only do horses. And then obviously the surgery is another specialty that we offer. Some of our future thoughts are to kind of see what the community needs. Do they need a medicine service? That's another specialty we could offer down the road. In terms of expansion into those other buildings, that's one of the things that I can see being useful as a medicine service. So kind of just starting on a small scale with this little front part. That part's kind of futuristic. This is kind of what we're looking at right now. And just gonna see, you know, start with a small footprint and a small staff and kind of expand a bit from there and see what the community needs and would support. So that's my basic, but if you guys have some questions, I'd be happy to answer them.
Educate me.
just like you go to a general practitioner maybe once a year to get a general checkup, vaccines, that sort of thing, animals get the same thing. But were you to have a hernia or some sort of GI problem that you needed surgery for, you wouldn't go to that person. You would go to a specialist that does surgery. So same as a medicine problem, something like a terrible pneumonia, you might go to a medicine specialist. So it's just one step beyond what a general practitioner would do.
Specialist, but not surgical.
Right, it's just a different field. There's dermatology specialists, there's ophthalmology specialists, there's neurology. That's why I say that would, I think, be the next specialty that we would offer, because it would be the next most likely to be needed in the area. But there's a million you could do. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
There's, there will be, obviously this will go to the Board of Supervisors before approval. They would require land development and that kind of stuff, which obviously these are started up. So those are conditions that don't need to be put on it because they're already there. They're automatically, because it's a commercial establishment and the amount of earth disturbance, they're going to need land development, they're going to need to work on soil conservation, that kind of stuff. So that's all built in already. Already a given requirement of the, so any conditions would be specific to this particular business. I really couldn't think of any at the time, so that's up to you guys.
Most of the conditions we don't want to put on place like this, as far as screening and things, I think it's going to be the opposite direction of what we normally do. You know, trying to screen the business from the rest of the community with the proximity of the interstate, knowing some of the lighting that's going on at the interchange, you may want to be doing the screening to keep the light away from your business.
Yeah, I mean, this isn't the kind of business that's going to make a lot of noise or glare or play music, which is normally what we end up dealing with.
Why did you mention that?
Because it seems like everybody wants that, but you're not going to band, right? Everybody wants that band, and then before you know it, there was, it's a thing about the hours.
Type of force therapy.
What time do you stop and the music? And so
no. I did read, through what you guys have online, and, you know, I guess what I will point out is it's different than a boarding facility. So a boarding facility is where people keep horses for a long time for pleasure, and they have certain pasture requirements and that sort of thing. But when horses are in a hospital, which is the idea here, they really only need small areas to go out in. A lot of times they're confined to stall rest for medical purposes. So I think some of the things that you have written about boarding facilities might not apply here.
Yeah, we didn't take any of that into consideration, because you're applying for an animal hospital, which is a completely separate definition.
It's kind of separate. So,
yes, it's absolutely separate.
Yeah.
And obviously, from a traffic standpoint, you're not talking about a significant impact of traffic. You're going to have the employees that are there. And if all things go well, probably not that many visits per day with horses
right.
coming in and out of it. They come, stay,
right.
get picked up, and it's not like you're in and out with a walk-in clinic like you would have at a normal veterinary clinic.
Do you have a potential staff set up, or is it you for now?
We have a couple people lined up, but mostly it's just us. We want to start kind of small and make sure we can earn enough to pay everyone at first, right? Small business plan at first. So we've been talking to Johnson College, and they have a technician training program, and we've been talking about possibly getting some anesthesiologists from over there, but also offering a service to them as well, because right now what they're doing with those students is to ship them out of the state to get the large animal part of their training. So once we get this up and functioning, that's something that we can help out with, is to help those students rotate through our hospital and get that part of their training. I spent the last couple of years in Canada as an assistant professor, teaching veterinary students, and I have my PhD in stem cell therapy. So
I must say, this is far more comprehensive than we normally see at this stage. Thank you.
This is section 408 of the ordinance, which again, you covered during the land development, is virtually, doesn't apply to this at all as far as lighting, glare, noise.
Right, that's the biggest concern I would have is anything coming from the interchange.
Yeah, you got a gas station feeding the store and a subway right next door, so if you're getting most traffic, it's steady traffic, you're going to be there, you know.
Just for a little bit of information, as some ideas they've been looking at for the building, I think it's pretty impressive. It was certainly impressive.
The builder, some of their handouts, I'll try to find the last few points that they built.
And it's going to be aesthetically impressive.
Yeah, it's a nice looking building, but this is some of the things they've done.
Look at the corner of the back.
I think Brad found it.
You know, that's another option. Please don't go, well, I don't have one.
Good location, my son and I want to do one where the trucks stop. Of course, they're not.
There's no sewer water there.
That's my point, I guess, is that they're one of the only people in Pennsylvania who built an equine hospital, which is a little different than building just a farm.
I'm thinking on probably has, I'm going to check the whole file.
Yeah, there's.
But I will check the whole check.
He said, check it out.
Yeah, I would have done it here. Chances are.
Done that.
Maybe we could get it to send a plan module.
Right, you send them a little hint to where they go up to drill, they can use what's in the other door.
Three, 4 months.
He was very quick to get back. Go that way.
That's great.
They use local.
For everything else, for me and for site work, I'm using as local as I can. But in terms of the build of like kind of a specialty building like that, I'm a little more comfortable doing it with someone who's done it before, so.
Understand.
Yeah, I feel like the community feels a little bit, I mean, actually, because you might as well do it later if you're going to do it, so.
They did point out that you missed out on Gucci's name on your list.
Oh.
A lot too miles away.
That was, we did that little search from Canada.
Yeah, we did that.
It's a fairly big word for me.
I know it is. We've met them, and we've been there several times.
Yeah.
It doesn't show up on Google, though.
It's amazing how many, you know, horse facilities, training facilities, boarding facilities there are in this area. Not to have the service, when you started talking about that, you know, oh, yeah, my brother-in-law had horses for a while in Greenfield Township, and they would always call us, and they didn't come in, or they'd be guarding the horse and taking it, like you said.
Yeah, and if you don't own a trailer, that costs about $400 or $500 to get someone to do that, just to take your animal to where their trailer goes, and then you have to start paying most people to do it. So you're already $500 in, and you're not even two extra help.
My brother-in-law has two package girls stable, so.
Oh, okay.
One way more than one way more.
Yeah, a lot of that business plan got written from Canada. We haven't even moved here yet.
People are patently aware of the local fire companies.
Uh-huh.
Anything in here that we would be concerned about? Not that this is deal breaker range stretch, just two questions we usually ask anybody doing new business with Francis Smith. What should we know about to protect us?
Mm-hmm.
And for you, what's your Alamo? If something bad were to happen, what do we need to say the most for you? Business continuity wise? Anything we would need to know if we have to.
Well, We're talking about putting a sprinkler system in, so I feel like that's a good thing. There would be oxygen lines, so you should know that. It would be just on the same level as any other, but a surgical, like a VRDC would have surgical
Again, that's a lines that for us, for the medical office, then.
So there would be oxygen lines, so that's sort of explosive nature. There's a nitrogen line, and, you know, obviously there's hay and things like that. So your regular barn fire worries are there, because part of it is sort of just where they stay, and so you're, that being said, we're smart enough not to put up wet hay, but it can happen.
It's gonna be in your cleaning arsenal.
Right.
If there's something that, for instance, didn't play well with water, how many things are now, but it's something we'd be interested in. A business that relocated into Township during the last year and a half, and we talked to them, turned out for their insurance underwriters, all their really nasty stuff, they made them take out of the main building, and they bought a little shed and put it outside, and he goes, all the nasties are out there. If it goes, it's probably on the ground by the time you guys get here.
Yeah.
But that's where the bad stuff is. So, good for us to know.
Okay. So flammable cleaning supplies is what you're saying, or things that don't react with water?
Things that don't want to react well with water.
We don't have anything like that. We do a lot of cleaning with water.
Right.
So we don't have anything like that.
That seems mature.
Yep. Yeah, I'll keep it in mind.
And we'll probably ask for a walkthrough so we know what we're facing.
Yeah, absolutely.
And how to attack.
We welcome that, because obviously we want communication possible.
The idea eventually is that it will be staffed 24 hours a day.
Yeah.
So there will be people there that can turn, that can get forces out if there's a fire.
Right.
Or something. Initially, there probably won't be that need, but if there's a horse there overnight, I think our goal is to have somebody there.
Yeah. As soon as that starts to happen, we'll have to staff it all night. And then that's part of the reason that we would fence everything, right? Mm-hmm. And that there would be a gate here. So I don't know where the fence would be right now, but probably something like this. At first, probably just through here, okay? And that's why there's a gate here, so that if you need to, you just throw the stall open and let them run out. And they're still contained. You just get them out. And, you know, obviously with this gate, we'll leave enough room that people can kind of pull in and wait for it to open and get through, and then it'll close behind them. There's a small bell at night that lets you know the gate's opening, that type of thing. But there again, that's how you keep them from ever getting loose on the roads and things like that.
I think that gate is set at about 80 feet from the road right now, which is any truck to get in there.
Yeah, we talked about setting it up.
You have a few people, you have room.
Yeah, well, and we don't anticipate six trucks in a row coming in there and having to go through the gate.
You can go for business, maybe, you know, at the same time.
Well, and if there were, I mean, they are kind of savvy enough that one sits here and then one waits here, right? Nobody goes halfway through the turn and waits. You have to be smart enough to drive something that big, I mean.
You might have made that with you.
You would phrase it, you're not afraid that they would be able to close.
So we had one of them turned sideways on the hill corner by the time the building is a snowstorm.
Well, that's kind of what drew us to this area, too. We looked for a very long time for an appropriate piece of land. What was really important to us was to be very close to 81 and the off-ramp, both for ease of people getting there and seeing it and that sort of thing, but also just for safety. These roads are going to be some of the first to get cleared and some of the safest to be on. And this stretch is kind of straight and flat, which is sort of a novelty around here, too. So it makes it a nice place to turn out slowly.
Well, only half a mile and it can change.
Yeah, well, exactly. But for that little stretch,
yes,
it really is a space you can pull out slowly, and that's comforting to clients.
Obviously, from a PennDOT standpoint, I'll be aware of an issue with site distance, and that's right. And as a matter of fact, just so the planning commission saw, at one point, Mr. Yablonski had filed for an HOP for that site, went partway through the process and withdrew. So we do have correspondence from PennDOT saying that the driveway location did meet site distance requirements and all the, you know, at least the preliminary checks that they went through. And I don't know what led to that, starting that process and withdrawing it, but we do have some correspondence on that, so.
That's good.
good news. I mean, I didn't anticipate a problem there, but not on that straight away. We've worked on much harder sites than this.
Just any concerns with Kennedy Creek, being an on-lot septic?
Being an on-lot septic in that area, which obviously would have to be sized for the water usage problem at the time. Department of Agriculture and DEP handle manure storage and regulation, and they're pretty adamant about that, so I don't think that would be an issue. They don't, you know, they're usually all over that with the impervious surface and has to be covered, so they can't, for some reason, they decided that horse manure is the worst in the world now. And so they're all over that.
Do you have to have your own pickup for, like, waste disposal, like, for bloody materials and antibiotic, medical stuff?
Definitely for, like, sharps containers and that sort of thing, and for deceased bodies, yeah. I think most of the cleaners that we use are pretty safe, though. There's nothing that's so toxic that it can't get on the ground or something. I mean, there's a lot of clinics like this in the U.S., and they're all in the country, so this is something that we're all used to dealing with in terms of not wrecking the land we're on. So.
Do public water out there?
It's well water.
Well water, yeah. Because there's important public from this.
One more reason that I don't want to mess it up.
Yes, you're on my well, so.
I thought that this is still within reach of the Sandy project.
Unless they're extending it, I don't believe so.
Okay. Not currently. No, I just don't think that when they figure out where the plume goes after the wells are kept.
Next round.
Yeah, that'd be the next round.
Okay. Anything? We don't have any action at this point, but the same reason.
Other than review this, make a motion to send it to the supervisors. Recommend approval without any.
Do they have any conditions that they see as necessary on this? That's how it's the normal zoning regulations. Promotion for this particular public comment. Rose, any public comment?
I think it's a fantastic idea because I love horses, so.
Okay.
I wish you were here years ago.
Good?
I'm good.
Okay. Promotion to forward this to the supervisor for their consideration.
Not to make a motion to forward it to the supervisors for their consideration.
Question? All those in favor?
Parker Hill, two times. That's further down.
Motion adjourned. Yeah, motion to adjourn.
Yeah, but there's no.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Return. Thank you for your time.
I need to be hearing you go.
We.
Away from Newfoundland.